It's 80 years since the bombing of Darwin, which remains to this day the largest attack on Australian soil by a foreign power. The Prime Minister attended a memorial service in the Northern Territory with a chilling reenactment as locals urged Australians to learn more about the Top End's history.
9:58 a.m. the air raid siren rings out as it did 80 years ago. On that day, it was sounded too late to give much warning.
80 years ago today, war came to Australia.
Today, a reenactment of the bombing of Darwin, which remains the single largest attack on Australia. It was on 19 February 1942 during the Second World War when Japanese warplanes appeared in the sky, the Top End targeted because of its crucial strategic position in the region, and yet it was underprepared.
On sea and on land, everything that moved was strafed or bombed.
252 personnel and civilians were killed, hundreds wounded, as 681 bombs rained down on Darwin, more than Pearl Harbor 10 weeks earlier.
People know more about Pearl Harbor than Darwin. I think it's time this to change. People should know more about what happened in Northern Australia during the war.
One person who knows too well is 101-year-old veteran Brian Winspear.
I looked up and the sun shone on the bombs, and you could see the bomb just like confetti.
The former gunner keeping spirits up as families and dignitaries paid their respects, politics put aside.
So our world has changed, our task remains to be prepared for any eventuality, to defend our values in a difficult world as it was done right here on this day 80 years ago.
Lest we forget.
Chloe Boris for 10 News First.